Hello and welcome back to Microsoft Mechanics Live. Coming up, we're going to take a look at end-to-end updates to device and app readiness for Windows 10 and Office 365 ProPlus as you make your shift to the modern desktop. We're going to show you your options to offer real-world guidance for getting off of older versions of Windows and Office, and all the updates coming to our telemetry and analytics tools that are going to help you create deployment plans, work through device, app, and Office add-in compat, as well as deeper integration with System Center, Configuration Manager, everyone's favorite tool. And today I'm joined by Amesh Mansukhani from the App and Device Readiness and Office team. Welcome.
Thanks, Jeremy. It's always great to be here.
All right, so I think most people watching right now are starting to kick off their rollout of Windows 10, whether they're on an older version of Windows 10 or a newer one, and going to Office 365 Pro Plus. Now, we've done a bunch of work in terms of building out the tools and resources. You can see here in our deployment process wheel, all of these things that we're working on, and your team specifically is working on the concept of basically device and app readiness, as well as some of the Office and LOB app delivery.
That's right. That's just about any deployment, right? The first step is to really is really about device and app readiness. Our team has been leveraging the intelligence gathered from millions of PCs. We've upgraded to Windows 10 and Office 365 Pro Plus and packaged the insights to help you make data-driven decisions about targeting the right devices for your deployments. Now, customers are telling us that they're seeing significant percentage of apps working in their new environment, but there's still some small percentage of apps, drivers, and even Office add-ins that could be an issue, and our service is designed to really highlight them so you can take action before it becomes a major operational issue.
All right, this sounds a lot like Windows Analytics. Is that an update to that?
Well, think of this as an evolution to Windows Analytics. This is a new service which was built from the ground up. Takes the best of Windows Analytics, enhances it with Office data along with new workflows and machine learning algorithms to ultimately help you reduce the overall workload when it comes to ongoing deployments. We call this new service Desktop Analytics, which will be in preview soon.
All right, let's see it.
What you're seeing here is the first thing that we show you on the home screen of our new dashboard is security updates as well as feature updates that cross Windows and Office.
Right, this is building on the existing capabilities that we had with Windows Analytics, but basically it's offering the Office insights for add-in compat in addition to Windows Insights, right?
That's right, Jeremy. We're bringing all this information into a single console. As you go down to the middle of the page, you'll see that not only there's a summary of your devices and apps, we also add the Office apps and add-ins. And then below here, we start showing you a diversity of your Windows and Office releases and versions.
But you're not taking away any of the detail and the depth of information that we add in Windows Analytics, right? So I see a pretty high-level dashboard here. Do we still get the same depth with this tool?
No, it even goes even further, right? With machine learning that's able to better understand your environment to make proactive recommendations. Where this really comes to life is within deployment plans, right? That actually give you information to help you validate your entire environment, right? Now, a deployment plan helps you efficiently get from your current version or release of Windows and Office to the future release by providing you with the right set of workflows to be able to get through that, to be able to help you prepare, pilot, and ultimately deploy your entire to your entire organization. Now, the best part is that we're deeply integrated with Configuration Manager, so you can define the devices that you want to target and build upon your deployment plan.
Right, so how does it actually work then with Config Manager? Is there some kind of a linkage
or
an add-in or something that you have to install?
Well, what we're doing today is we're leveraging the device collection inventory information in Configuration Manager and publishing it with a newly built microservice to send that information into Desktop Analytics.
Cool.
Now, as you can see here, as I create a sample deployment plan, I'm able to go in and select the actual device collection, set it as my target, and create my actual deployment from here.
Got it.
Then I can, as I go through future states, I'm able to then go back into Configuration Manager and have that information sent over, and then be able to determine which devices are actually ready to go, and then be able to create things like a phased deployment to be able to move those along.
Very cool. So it's actually recommending all the things that you have to do to kind of get the right pilot group, kind of start to create and kind of populate your collections, make sure you can deploy successfully. But what's the next thing you have to do?
Well, but one thing I want to tell you is think of analytics as the actual recipe to build your deployment plan and use Configuration Manager to be the chef to actually make those deployments happen. Let me show you how analytics can help to reduce the overall workload through shared insights and data-driven validation. The first thing you'll do is you want to identify your important assets within your organization. Mm-hmm. In this screen, you'll see a list of noteworthy applications that are installed in greater than 2% of your devices. As you review them, you will mark the ones that you want as critical. As you can see over here, I can mark it as critical or important. And then once you're done with these steps, we'll go to the next step of actually identifying your actual pilot devices, right? And over here, what we're going to do is we're going to give you a recommendation based on the diversity of the devices, make, and models, and mark them either critical or important from there.
So can we include or exclude devices? For example, if my IT team maybe want to be part of the pilot, but let's say I value my job and don't want to start delivering pre-release builds to my CEO or my CIO. Can I exclude the users as well?
You know, we've gotten a lot of that feedback. And in this scenario, we give you the flexibility to set a list of devices that should always be included and a list of devices that should always be excluded. And then we'll overlay our algorithm. We will then provide you a recommendation that ensures that you can hit obtain 100% coverage with a high number of redundancy. This is mainly to ensure that we have more than one device available in the event of that device being offline for a significant period of time.
Makes sense. So what happens then after we identify our set of pilot devices here? We can see we've got around 100% coverage. Where do we go next?
So from there, we go ahead and prepare our pilot devices for known issues. So we give you a curated list of all the Microsoft known issues where I can then go and start looking at them, remediate them. And this, an example, we'll look at particular driver, and which will probably tell us that, you know, it's going to have a problem, which we're going to want to go ahead and remediate for that. That information gets sent directly to Configuration Manager, which then the admin can do the pre or post action appropriately.
Cool, that's going to help a lot of us then reduce the time and amount of validation time. Plus, we're getting kind of data-driven insights for all of this. And you've shown some known issues, and you can share them ahead of time in terms of your testing efforts. So it's not this manual process that we had to go through before that was kind of painful, frankly. You might have had people running VMs to test the line of business apps, so it didn't affect their production work. Now all of this is kind of data-driven. What other help is there that we can provide?
Well, after we've informed ConfigMan that these devices are ready to upgrade and the admin has done all the remediation necessary, we could start going and looking at the deployment status. Here we give you, in aggregate, all the particular issues that are occurring, anything from like disk full to other failure effects, and then telling you exactly which of the devices that are affected.
OK, so I can't tell you how many times I've been testing apps or waiting to hear whether or not maybe a fix that I've built, a transform file that I've put in between the MSI and the actual OS is working. This way, hopefully, the I don't have to wait for you to call me as to whether or not something's broken. It's going to actually tell me this proactively, right?
That's right. Yeah, so you're not waiting for your help desk or operations team to actually surface that information. We give you we give you this information directly in the console itself.
Right. And how does this all work?
So. Beyond that, what we're going to be able to do is then be looking at all your actual devices and your assets and start telling you how well or healthy they are based on the health status, right?
Very cool.
So our machine learning algorithm will then inform you on which ones are meeting goals or actually need attention. And in this case, we see a number of devices that are currently meeting goals, which we're going to want to go and sign off and then move forward into our overall deployment, which we're just going to rinse and repeat. That's how we're going to unblock these devices and move them all to our production users.
Very cool. So it's kind of like, at this point, we've got all the data. They're all marked, ready for deployment in this case. Are we ready to start doing production deployment, or what's the next step?
Definitely, all right there. So what we can do is we can go back into our overall plan. We'll see a number of devices that are ready to deploy and start rinse and repeating all those critical steps that we just talked about.
Awesome. So this is going to help you then basically get all of kind of the data-driven insights, get ready for the deployment stage. And it's really about making sure that everything's ready, that you're confident, that you've got all the data to make this decision, because you don't want to throw something over the fence and then wait for something to break before you kind of start to reel that back. You've got some of these options with upgrade task sequences and things to kind of roll back if you need to, but it's way better if you've got this proactive information here. So Config Manager also has a lot of information as well, or a lot of upgrades, I would say, and things that we've done on the networking side. If we follow the wheel, as Toucan Sam might say, we can say, let's look at directory and network readiness, and some of the optimizations that we've done there are pretty significant. First, the things that a lot of people have been asking for, if you're a Configuration Manager admin, I think many people have Config Manager, right? It's pretty much every hand will probably go up. So one of the cool things that we've done is we've added peer cache. So we've got the peer cache support. We can do things like delivery optimization, peer cache. We've had branch cache for a long time. But basically, that's taking all the traffic, moving it closer to the edge so that you're not kind of saturating your VPN lines and things to manage your endpoints and doing it through peer-to-peer work. So something a lot of people have been asking for that's part of this as well in terms of delivering, getting your network prepared. Another thing you're going to want to do as part of this is also getting Azure AD implemented. And one more thing that I love about the updates to Config Manager is the integration with Leadbat, part of Server 2016. Now, if you're not familiar with this, if you think about throttling, normally you take that 20% stripe, or it's probably going to be less, but using bits or something to be able to transfer large deployment files over the network, either between DPs or from the DP to the endpoints. Now what you can do is basically have background tasks use Leadbat that's basically consuming all of your network bandwidth. If it sees that there's foreground traffic, the user's trying to watch a video, download an app, do whatever, it's actually going to yield all that traffic bandwidth for that foreground task. So the user doesn't feel it, but instead of waiting a week to get a WIM file down to a machine, you might be able to do it in a day or less, depending on how good your network is. So this is really cool stuff in terms of network optimization. Now, one other thing that I love about this is it's just one checkbox in order to get that running as part of your distribution point general tab. In those settings there, if you adjust the download speed to use unused network bandwidth using Leadbat, that's all you have to do to configure it, and it's running, it's off to the races. So really cool. Amesh, we've seen a couple of things around readiness and the network itself, our infrastructure. Now we know our devices and our apps are ready. Now the next phase is really to look at app delivery and kind of getting our office clients out there. And I think a lot of people are probably pretty familiar with MSI packaging and the options that they have there. But you're also our expert, resident expert on Click to Run. Why don't you tell us what's new there?
Well,
for Office.
As we recently announced, Click to Run is the only package type for Office you'll use for deployments. And we have enhanced our existing tools to ensure that we've made deployment easier. Let me show you how, right? First, we've updated the Office customization tool to power the Office install wizard within Configuration Manager. Right? This will enable our team to deliver updates of installation settings sooner than wait for the next version of Office to be, or the next release of actual Configuration Manager. As you can see here, this workflow is fully integrated into Configuration Manager, where I can type in things like my organization. I can then go in and look at and pick a product that I want. Here, I'll take the example of ProPlus, scroll that down a little bit, make sure that we don't have Groove installed, and I can start adding all this information directly into here, and then pick a language. Go ahead and I'll pick Dutch, for example, and I click Next. And all of this information is then directly put within Configuration Manager, where we can just go into the standard workflow.
But we'd be remiss if we didn't talk about the installation settings, because there's some really cool stuff that we've added there
well,
right?
Let me kind of show you. And I'm going to use the existing config.office.com. Now, again, this is the same kind of set of settings
just,
that we have.
Just pay attention to this URL, config.office.com, if you want to start playing for this and building out your own config.xml file effectively with all the different configurations. You can do this now. It's open. It's on the internet. And it's part of Configuration Manager, as we saw before, integrated as part of that GUI.
Right. So again, from ConfigMan 1806 onwards, any changes that we make on config.office.com automatically get sent over to Configuration Manager. So you have all that information directly
there.
Why
don't you drop down that installation settings?
Let's go with the installation settings. So one thing I want to be able to show you here, actually, it's going to be right here.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah. So we have two key things right here. For those of you who are moving from Click to Run 2013 version, instead of uninstalling that and reinstalling the latest Pro Plus, we actually have a single click button right here that allows you to do that. We make that all that happen in the background. Now, the other thing that we've done, if you're using scripts today to uninstall and clean up any of your pesky reg keys and then finally install that, we actually built that into the setup file.
So no more off scrub.
An over off scrub.
All right. This is right. Something a lot of people, I think, have been asking for. So the nice thing is we get to actually change the MSI into Click to Run and do that without using some, VB script in the background.
Right. But wait, there's more.
Okay.
Right. Now, the other thing I want to show you is we're now introducing application settings. These are the same set of settings that you've had in traditional OCT for MSI, right?
Right.
Where I can now go in, pick up a couple of settings, and then be able to configure that directly here and have that set up directly into my XML file.
We don't have to package up like MST or MSP files along with our Office packages. This is the XML, right?
Just the XML. And you can not only just do it during install time, you can do it post as well.
Very cool. And you have to set up, before you had to set up group policy effectively to do all of this stuff, and now this granularity of configuration, now it's just part of OCT, and you can do all that via preferences, which is way more handy, and it's not as enforced, I guess, as group policy, but it's what a lot of people tend to want to do anyway.
Right, but on that note of group policy, we're also introducing a new service that allows you to create new policies and then be able to target these policies to different groups of users via the cloud and no longer need the necessary GPOs to do
so
that.
So you don't need the domain controller or any of that infrastructure to do
that? Not at all. So if I log into this machine or your machine, it will automatically recognize who I am and then download those policies and have them affected directly to me.
Wow, that's excellent. Yep. You guys can clap if you want. That's been an awesome thing that people have been asking for. I know I've had the complaints, the requests, those things come in, so this is great to see.
You know what we've been going through, right? Yeah. So now the other thing I want to also introduce to you is our security policy advisor.
Okay.
Now this allows us to really understand what is going on within your environment and to increase that overall security posture. So for example, if I look at these Word devices right here, I can see that there's a number of target users that are actually not using Word, and I can quickly apply these settings directly to them, and then they'll get those policies based off that.
Awesome, awesome stuff. So many updates that we've got across the board, really, when you think about, if we go back to, you know, our kind of thinking about the wheel, both on the app and device readiness side, the networking side, app delivery, and all the policy management that we can do there, all these things that we've done to accelerate our deployments for ProPlus. Of course, remember that you have to be on the current branch for Config Manager to take advantage of a lot of this stuff, but you can start playing with things like config.office.com. Any closing thoughts, though, Amesh? Where should people go to actually learn more?
Well, to take advantage of the insights, and if you haven't done so already, I want you to start having the conversation with your respective teams about turning on telemetry in your environment. Yeah, and don't forget to start making that shift. Get on Office 365 Pro Plus. Get on Windows 10 to make that happen. And so you can learn more on the Modern Desktop Deployment Center. And by following us on the series of Desktop Deployment Essentials.
Yeah, Desktop Deployment Essentials is a brand new series that we have. It's 10 parts. It follows every step in the deployment process wheel that we have. Everything we go in depth with all the demos, all the different tools that you're going to use across your deployment projects. And staying current after you get to Windows 10 and Office 365 Pro Plus. So stay tuned to that. That's all the time we have for today's show. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.